Thank you, folks, and welcome. Thank you for all coming out tonight. I'm the Rich Fenstermaker, the chair of the Somerset Berkeley Regional High School Building Committee. And what we'd like to do tonight is just kind of give you a brief presentation on the process we're going through, how we got started, where we're going, and the various steps to get to a new high school. Okay. First, we're going to start off with the timeline of how we got to where we are today. Back in the fall of 2001, the Somerset School Committee initiated a 10-year capital improvement plan for the school district. From that plan, there was a determination made that the most pressing issue for the community at that time was the high school. So a high school feasibility study was completed in March of 2004. The study committee was created by the Board of Selectmen, made up of various people throughout the community, some of which are here tonight, Ms. Stone and others. And the recommendation of that committee was that the town of Somerset build a new high school. After looking at the cost of renovating the existing school, which is really what the feasibility study was planned to do, we looked at the cost of that renovation and some of the challenges, and looked at the cost at that time in 2004 of a new facility to go with it forward with a new facility. At the time that determination was made, the state had in place a moratorium on school building. We had to wait 3 years for that moratorium to be lifted, and at that time, a project application was filed with the state for the MSBA. So the town, both the town of Somerset and the town of Berkeley submitted statements of interest to build a new high school. In the case of Berkeley, it was going to be a junior senior high school, and Somerset was for a high school only. The MSBA put both projects on hold pending a regionalization review. Main reason being for that in both communities we were counting the Berkeley High School students as part of the project, and the Berkeley students really needed to have a permanent home before the state was going to move forward with funding of a new project. A board was appointed to explore formal regionalization between Somerset and Berkeley in 2009. As we all know, in 2010, the votes to regionalize the new district was accepted into the MSBA model school program. From that, the interim regional school committee was formed, and then the regional school committee then appointed the building committee. The building committee is comprised of 20 people from both communities with various experience in building trades, architects, engineers, educators, and parents. So we got a good cross-section of folks involved in the process, and we welcome your comment and feedback as we go through this. The forum will be very open as we go through the process. We'll invite others from the community to join us. With that, I will pass it over to Stephanie Field.
Good evening. Thank you for taking the time out of your evening to come and listen to our presentation. As Rich mentioned, my name is Stephanie Field. I am a resident of Somerset. I'm also an alum of Somerset High and the Somerset School System. And my motivation for being involved in this project is to give our kids the tools that they'll need to compete in today's world. And I'm thrilled to be part of this project, and again, thank you. So for tonight's agenda, we're going to go a little bit through the model school process. We're then going to go into frequently asked questions. We're then going to end with building our future together, and then open it up for any questions that you may have from the group. So the MSBA model school process. The MSBA model school program is a grant program, and when a district is asked or invited into that program, there's a series of steps that the district must follow in order for the process to continue. In an attempt to break these tasks into more manageable pieces, the building committee has broken this into a three-phase process. We're currently in phase one of that process, and what that is to complete and submit MSBA initial documentation, transfer land building to the region, which will have to happen in a Somerset vote, secure funding for initial design through preparation construction documents, and this will also happen on a Somerset vote on February 7th. It's important to note that Berkeley has already approved the initial borrowing for these funds and have also secured $40,000 towards the interim region's first year operational costs. The first part of that, of the design preparation, will be to select an owner's project manager procurement and then do the model school designer selection. Once we've secured funding and we've transferred the land, we can then move to phase two of the process. I'm going to bring up some timelines here. Please keep in mind that these are just timelines. They could be affected by MSBA board meetings as well as local town board meetings. But this is the time frame that we're working on now. As this time frame changes, we will update the website, which the building committee will show you at the end of the presentation where you can find all that information. And we'll make sure that we have the most up-to-date information listed there. As we move into phase two, once we've transferred the land and secured the funding for the first part, we then enter into design development. We will present to the MSBA board for their approval preliminary design, and we will establish a scope, budget, and schedule. We'll have building schematics, construction documents, and both towns will then vote on the final design and funding. One thing that the building committee is committed to doing is keeping both towns involved in the process. We have not decided on a model for the school. We will leave that up to the public to give their opinion, and then the building committee will take that under consideration before anything is submitted to the MSBA. So both communities will have the opportunity to comment on those designs. And we're hoping to have this accomplished between March 2011 and November 2011. Once we've secured final funding, we then move into phase three. And this is when we actually break ground. So the district will have secured financial support of final project and will enter into a project funding agreement. This is when we will do construction administration and process, building completion, and project closeout. And we're hoping to have this completed by June 2014. At this point, I'm going to turn it over to Bob Camara, who will handle frequently asked questions.
Hi folks, as Stephanie said, I'm Bob Kinnar, also a Somerset resident and part of the Regional School Building Committee. I'm going to go over the frequently asked questions, and we've expounded on these since we've been doing this. This is our fourth or fifth presentation, so we try to wrap in any of the questions that we get into the presentation. So let's just get rolling. Is the MSBA funding still guaranteed? Yes, it is still guaranteed. The MSBA funding for this project is not affected by any of the state budget cuts. And it comes from a penny on every dollar raised with a sales tax. And the MSBA board, as Rich said, voted to 2009 to set aside the funds for this project. So is that initial funding that's going to be requested on the 7th by the region previously estimated costs? And it's not. It's actually part of the total estimated cost for the project, which is $70 million. And that includes all the technology, the furnishing, and basic fields. The $3.6 million of the total is estimated for the project management, design, and construction, as Julie talked about. It's reimbursable by MSBA, the same rates as the full project, the 66.3%. And Berkeley and Somerset are responsible for the balance. We're responsible for 75% of that balance, Berkeley for 25%. And any amount of this project on these initial costs that's not used will be directed towards the other construction costs. So we're not just spending it all. If we save it, it's going to go into the project. And then the building committee is going to be working with the MSBA to use state and local funds wisely in building this project. So is it necessary to transfer the land to the region? Yes, it is. The land must be owned, according to MSBA, by the region to participate in this model school program and receive the funding. Somerset will retain the use of land as a partner in the high school region, as well as for town use, community purposes, what have you. And as part of the region, Berkeley will be contributing to demolition construction costs, as we are. And if the region should ever dissolve, it would be the property would revert back to the town of Somerset. There's a question we've been getting a lot lately. Can the historical character of the building be maintained? Yes. The historical character can be replicated in the model school program. It's been replicated in Norwood and Plymouth North. And the options are going to be explored and evaluated by the committee as part of the building process. We've seen, and you'll see some different photos here. Every school district has done it differently. Some of them wrapped it in. Some of them have gone with a totally new design. And I think, as we've said in the past, this is a learning process. This is also a collaborative process. We want the towns, we want the folks in both communities to be involved as we move forward. We have not picked any style. There's three models right now, and I'm going to show you a couple of examples that we have here. And as I said, it's an opportunity to collaborate. What Whitman Hansen had done is designate historical markers inside their building, which sort of captured the essence of that community, even though they went with a style that didn't resemble existing buildings. They used that as a way of continuing the legacy and supporting their education. Things that can be done are a foyer display in the building, commemorative space outside, green space, things like that that would be designated for historical purposes. All right, for the new Norwood Model School, the Whitman Hansen design that you see up here was modified to resemble the former building. So the one on the left is the current Norwood High School, soon to be former, and the one on the right is the new one. So you see they've captured the character that the facade has in the original, while still making sure they've got a state-of-the-art facility. This is a better view of the entire site. We put this one up because it, while it doesn't match Somerset's site exactly, it gives you a sense of what they're doing, how they stage the construction. And see if this laser thing will work. All right, here you've got the existing Norwood High School, and they're building in the back behind. You see that they're prepping for fields over here. And so this is the construction. I guess this is one of the last photographs. I think it's October or November of last year. So again, what they've done is they've maintained use of the existing structure while they're working on the new one. All right, we've gotten this a lot. What's the condition of the 1936 building? And I know quite a few of you are probably interested in taking a tour after this forum of the 36 portion of the building. In 2004, the report, the Castle Blues report, estimated the cost of renovations at about 5.7 to 8.5 million. And according to the study, the 1936 structure is not recommended for classroom use because, in their words, reusing the 1936 structure would perpetuate an undesirable educational condition in the future, which is something we certainly don't want here. It's suitable only for office space, and that cost range above that 5.7, 8.5 is for office space renovation. And the 2004 building study that Rich mentioned earlier, they voted to recommend the new school rather than renovate. Recently, in talking with the school department management, said in 2008 the condition survey of the slate roof on the 1936 portion estimated at between $250,000 for an asphalt roof or $900,000 for a slate roof, which it currently has. And that is separate and apart from that $5.7 to $8.5 million estimate. And then emergency repairs have been made, but the building has continued to deteriorate. So what's the impact of saving the 1936 portion of the building? The citizen's petition requires the 36 portion be maintained as part of the Somerset Berkeley Regional High School District. In 2009, MSBA invited Somerset and Berkeley into the model school program as a region, offering that 66.3% reimbursement for the new state-of-the-art building. If the citizen's petition passes, we delay the building project, increasing operating and construction costs, and impact the reimbursement, which amounts to about $46.2 million. That's the estimate. Or the golden ticket, as Julie refers to. All right.
Thank you. So based on all this information that has been compiled since 2002, let's look at some of the conclusions that we've made. So the MSBA recently stated that including the 1936 building as part of the region would require a new MSBA board approval and a new feasibility study. It would add 6 to 12 months to the study and design phases of the project, increase the design costs, and eliminate 5 incentive or reimbursement points. And I apologize that some of our words might be cut out there, at least they look cut out over here. But what that translates to, those 5 incentive points, $3.5 million of that 46.2 could be in jeopardy by modifying the process, not to mention delaying the entire process. And what we've looked at is, based on past feasibility studies, the 1936 building is not viable for educational purposes. And as such, our building committee at their last meeting voted that it will not be considered as part of the building project except for demolition purposes. So if that's the case, let's keep in mind that the cost of renovation, maintenance, and possible future demolition would then be the sole responsibility of Somerset taxpayers. We've already given you some estimates of what that might be. And another important thing to keep in mind is, not only have we determined it's not usable for educational purposes, but town officials have indicated that at this point there is no anticipated use for that structure. So with all that combined, all that information, all those facts, the building committee, the regional school committee, and the Somerset school committees have all recommended that the town not approve the citizen's petition as written. So with that kind of as a framework, let's talk about the future and this cause of building our future together. It is not just simply Somerset and Berkeley, but all of us together working. As Stephanie mentioned, we will be holding forums throughout this process. We will be coming to you for feedback. We will be keeping you informed. And it will require everyone's vote on February 7th in order to even get us to that next step. And what we've assured you is that the building committee will work with the MSBA to use state and local, I should say local, funding wisely in building a state-of-the-art facility. Back in 2009, we were given what we refer to as a golden ticket, that 66.3% reimbursement from the MSBA. But that's not a coupon. That's not a coupon for us to go and spend more than we need to spend. We will use that efficiently and effectively to make sure we get the most we can for the students in this region. And as we mentioned prior, Stephanie mentioned that a lot of our decisions, because we're going to be working so closely with the MSBA, as we should, they're a big stakeholder in this project, we're going to have to tie into some of their board meetings, and they meet every six weeks. So if there's a delay at any point in this process, let's say with the vote that's supposed to happen on February 7th, that could mean a six-month delay could actually delay the building for a year or more. And as I said in the previous slide, if we continue to look at maintaining that 1936 building, we essentially have to start over with the MSBA. And delays mean missing out on lower construction and design costs, ultimately costing taxpayers. In other words, right now is a great time to start this project. And it will ultimately save taxpayers if we're able to capitalize on the economy as it is right now. While we wait to build, maintenance costs could increase on an already aging building. There have already been emergency repairs done in the last few years. And as we wait, those emergency repairs could increase. NEAS report already provided a timeline, a two-year timeline, for improvement to the site as part of its accreditation. And we all know how important that is. And let's not forget that each year that goes by, additional graduating classes lose out on the opportunity to benefit from a new state-of-the-art building. Again, we're doing this for the children in these two communities. We need to keep that in mind. So it is imperative that Somerset votes on February 7th. Vote yes to transfer the land and buildings to the Somerset Berkeley Regional High School District. I don't know why it's cutting that off, but it's Somerset Berkeley Regional High School District. And that's very important. Without this transfer, which was stipulated in the agreement we all approved last June, without this transfer happening now, with a two-thirds vote, this process cannot continue. We ask you to vote yes to provide the region with the initial funding that is necessary to begin the process. Again, without that approved funding, and as we said, we will use that funding wisely, and any money not spent in the initial phase will be directed towards the construction phase later on. Let me just point out that Norwood is one of the more recent schools that was built, And that, again, was estimated at a cost of $70 million, just as ours was estimated at $70 million. And they came in at $68 million, even making modifications so that it reflected the historical character of its previous building. And it was finished ahead of schedule. So again, we'd like to get started, but we need these votes in order for that to happen. And we also ask you to vote no to the citizen's petition, which requires the region to maintain the 1936 portion of the high school as part of that region. So with all that said, we want to thank you for coming out and learning these facts. We would like you to ask questions and also spread the news out there of how important this February 7th meeting is, and encourage your neighbors and friends and family who live in Somerset to attend. Without your help, we cannot move forward, and we need it in order to start building this future together. And as Stephanie mentioned, we have developed a website. Our goal this year is to, and throughout the process, is to try to keep the communities as informed as possible. We will keep you updated. We have minutes of our meetings posted there. We have schematics from other buildings posted there. And we will try to update that on a very regular basis so that you know where we are in the process. So at this point, I'd like to thank you very much and turn it over to any questions you may have. Oh, come on. Any questions? No, we've been adding slides as we've gone to each presentation, so maybe we were able to address all the questions. But does anybody have?
I think they all want to take the tour.
Yes.
What happens if at that February 7th meeting you don't have a two-thirds majority vote for the land transfer?
Well, I think what the MSBA has said, if we're close, we can try again at another meeting. But again, every delay that we have. For example, if we're able to get this done at this February 7th meeting, we're hoping to tie into a March 9th MSBA meeting so that we can get that first stage approved and move forward. Without that, we may miss the March meeting and then be set back considerably because of that. So it is extremely important that we're able to do this. And it was, in fact, it's expressly written in the agreement that was approved by the voters last year.
I was just going to add that on the website that you see noted there, you might make note of that, because that Castle Groves report that we referred to throughout this on estimates of cost and condition of building, that whole report is posted on that website under frequently asked questions section of the website. So any question you might have on the detail and how we came up with some of the numbers that we're presenting, the information we have presented, the detail is in there. It's a pretty comprehensive report that's included there. And on one of the slides, as Julie mentioned, a couple of these slides get cut off a little bit. And one of them, I think Mr. Camaro was presenting, and it was the one about the question, is the $3.6 million part of the overall project? And the way it was worded up there on the screen, you'd think it wasn't, but it is. Just in case you read that the way that you could see it up there, it is part of the whole $70 million project, the way it was presented.
Building committee working with the state, or is the building committee making recommendations to the regional committee, who is then presenting their decision to the state? For instance, if there's going to be design changes for the people on the building committee in Somerset want the facade that is going to incur a significant cost, in Berkeley people don't feel that they want to bear the burden for that facade. Is it the building committee that's going to make the recommendation to the state, or is it the regional committee?
Well, the building committee has both representatives from Somerset and Berkeley, so we'll be able to talk about that. And that I think we're working concurrently, because, as a matter of fact, for the enrollment estimates, it is a joint group of people from both the regional school district school committee and the building committee that are working on developing the enrollment statistics right now with the MSBA.
But the building committee's recommendation would be the final recommendation to the state? Does it have to go to the...
Well, it's a hand-in-hand, we're working this together. And what we'll do is, through our process, that design's not going to be just, picked overnight. We're going to have a number of public forums where we'll be able to look at different designs. But it's going to be the building committee's responsibility is to to choose a design that's most adequate for our, you know, our purposes. So that's our charge.
And that becomes the final say.
Well, the final say comes back to the voters eventually. When you get, obviously, the reason we have all this input and make sure everyone's on board with this every step of the way is we don't want to go through this whole process and get to town meetings later in the year and have people say, well, we don't like that building, so we're not going to vote for it. So the process is going to be open all the way through. Is to say there's a final say, I mean, there's going to be a recommendation, yes. I mean, that's kind of what our charge is, and that's why we have the people that, you know, the variety of people working on this committee are going to make that recommendation.
But that's that final decision is actually part of the vote.
Right.
So both towns are going to vote on that.
So, for example, throughout the process, we're going to be looking for public input for what these designs are. But ultimately, it will be the responsibility of this building committee to then put forth to the townspeople. And our estimate was from November of 2011. This is the design. This is how much it's going to cost. And this is why we're recommending it. So that's basically how it will proceed.
I think the question is the building committee working with MSBA, or is the building committee working with the regional school committee to work with the MSBA?
The building committee has a direct link with the MSBA as far as the project goes. As far as the project goes. The enrollment numbers, and this is where we talk about that right now, our square footage of the building is going to be based on the enrollment number. The enrollment number has, responsibility is a negotiation, I guess, between the MSBA and the interim regional school committee, because that's, you know, that's going to, the number of students dictates the square footage for the building that we could build. So it's kind of a dual process. It's all, but every step of the way, we have in most cases we have on our building committee members of the regional school committee. The chair of the interim regional school committee is normally at our meetings, though not formally a member of the building committee. So there's plenty of interaction, you know, and there's members of the Somerset school committee and the Berkeley school committee on the building committee. So all that input is all coming together all the way through the process. Mrs. Souza, did you have a question?
No, I think you answered it.
Okay.
The clarification is that the townspeople of both towns have the final say.
Yes.
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 Yes. Yes. Yes.
My name is Rick Pierce, and I'm a member of the Interim Regional School Committee and also one of the designees to the Regional School Building Committee. And I just wanted to share with people, I've shared this at other forums, the Regional School Building Committee had the opportunity to visit the Whitman Hansen High School, which is one of the model schools. And my thought going before the visit was that I really didn't know what to expect, but I didn't have the greatest of expectations, knowing that this was a model school, thinking it was kind of a cookie cutter type of building. And actually seeing the Whitman Hansen School really excited me about this project. It really is a remarkable facility. One of the reasons that it is because through this model school program, you really get the maximum value for your money, because you have a building that's been designed and is being reused. So the facility, when they first designed it, they wanted it to be the kind of facility that was worthwhile for the state to support, because the state has committed 1 cent of every sales tax dollar to building new schools across the state. And while no specific model, there are three possible models, we haven't made any decisions, the building committee hasn't made any decision about which model we might use. The Whitman Hansen model has been used at least 3 times already. Used in Whitman Hansen, used in Norwood, and used at Plymouth North. And each time it's been used, it's been improved. As people live in the building, they see little things that might be changed to improve it. And that has actually happened in each case. And in each case that the model school was used, both in Norwood and in Plymouth, the local school building committee was able to configure the building in a way that they thought was consistent with the desires of the community. You saw what they did in Norwood. They did a similar kind of thing in Plymouth to design their building so that it resembled the character of the building that had previously existed in the community. But the facilities in these buildings are fabulous for the kids, and I'm really excited about the prospect of having that kind of a building in Somerset. The gymnasium, and this might sound extravagant, but it really isn't, because it's part of a model program, so it makes it much more affordable. The gymnasium in the building, which are pretty much standard, is probably twice the size of the gymnasium that we have. It can accommodate two basketball games at the same time, literally. The auditorium that is there is state-of-the-art. It's a fabulous facility. The communities of Whitman and Hanson use the facility for other kinds of programs. The night we were there, there were community activities going on. There's an indoor walking track that's available to the community. So I want you to know that this is a fabulous opportunity for our community. We're being offered this kind of a facility with the state paying 66% of the cost. The money is set aside. It's sitting there waiting for us to use. But if we don't act promptly and use the money, there are many other communities across the Commonwealth that are clamoring for that kind of money and that kind of facility in their community. So I hope everybody really will talk to your friends, fellow parents, and urge them to come out for the special town meeting on February 7th, because it's critical that we get a two-thirds vote for the transfer of the land if the project is going to move forward. And I thank you. I have to run because I'm doing another presentation in another location in town tonight. So thank you very much for your attention.
Anyone else?
Any other comments or questions?
We will be offering a brief tour of the 1936 building now. If anyone is interested in doing that, they're welcome to join us. If you want to see the highlights of the 36 building, if you will. We just wanted to offer that opportunity for anyone that might be interested in doing that. And if there are no further questions, then we'll adjourn the session. Thank you very much for coming out tonight.